Hello students, welcome to the lesson 2 of the introductory concepts from this subject Advanced Structural Analysis. So the topic of this particular lesson is static and kinematic indeterminacy. So here basically we will be studying what is static indeterminacy, what is kinematic indeterminacy, and what are the formulas which are used to find the degree of static and kinematic indeterminacy. Okay, so in the previous chapter you already have learned how to identify a determinate and an indeterminate structure. Now indeterminate structure are basically of two types. It can be statically indeterminate or it can be kinematically indeterminate. Okay, so let's see one by one. First let us see the definition of static indeterminacy. This is also called as degree of redundancy. Redundancy is nothing but more or extra. Now why the name static is, we already know that there are three equations of equilibrium if we take a 2D structure, correct? What are the three equations of equilibrium? Sum of horizontal forces equal to 0, sum of vertical forces equal to 0, and sum of moment equal to 0. So in any structure we can find three unknowns easily using the three equations of equilibrium if it is a 2D structure, correct? Now if there are more than three unknowns, then the extra numbers whatever we have, thus that is known as static indeterminacy or degree of redundancy. Also let's see the exact definition. So it is the number of equations which is required over and above the equations of static equilibrium for the analysis of a structure. So normally three we can find easily using the static equilibrium equations, but more than three we cannot find. So whatever is the number more than three, that will be considered as degree of static indeterminacy or degree of redundancy. If you want to see an example, consider a fixed beam like this. So how many reactions will a fixed beam have? Three reactions, right? So three reactions, three equations of equilibrium, so the total subtraction value will become 0. So that becomes a determinate structure. If in case you change this to a propped cantilever beam, what will happen in this case? How many reactions are there? 4 reactions are there. But we usually have how many equations of equilibrium? 3 equations of equilibrium, right? So it becomes 1. The subtraction becomes 1. So this becomes a indeterminate structure. And what is the degree of indeterminacy? Degree of indeterminacy is this value 1. So one extra equation is required in order to analyze the structure in this particular propped cantilever case. So that particular one will become the degree of static indeterminacy or degree of redundancy. This is just an example I have considered. Okay. Now a structure can be statically indeterminate in three ways. How many ways? In three ways a structure can be statically indeterminate. Now what are these? Let's see. So types of statically indeterminate structure. First one is externally indeterminate. So a structure can be externally indeterminate. We'll give the notation as DSE. The static indeterminacy notation is DS. Okay. A structure can be externally indeterminate or it can be internally indeterminate. So we'll call it as DSI. Okay. And the last one is the structure can be both externally as well as internally indeterminate. So if both the things have a value, then they become externally and internally indeterminate. Okay. So now your static indeterminacy is sum of A and B. Now let us see the formula on how to find your static indeterminacy. So the formula is like this. DS is equal to DSE plus DSI minus number of internal hinges. So what are internal hinges? Any hinge which is there in the structure, in a member, that's called as an internal hinge. Here the moment will not be, it is, the moment will be 0 in this case. This can easily have rotation at this particular point. Okay. So what is DS? Total static indeterminacy. What is DSE? It's your external indeterminacy, and DSI is your internal indeterminacy. So DSE is always related to support reaction. So the number of support reactions which are there in a structure, based on that your external indeterminacy can be determined. Whereas your internal indeterminacy is related to the type of joint or frame. is related to what? Frame. Whether the joint is rigid or whether the joint is flexible or whether the joint is pinned, based on that it will be related. Or it will also be related to your internal configuration. Nothing but your structure is built. Based on that, your internal indeterminacy will be determined. Now, let us see individually how to calculate your external and internal indeterminacy. So, if you know how to calculate external and internal indeterminacy and also know how many number of internal hinges are there, you can find the static indeterminacy very easily. Now, the external indeterminacy can be calculated using a formula like this. So, what is your external indeterminacy? R minus E. So, where R is nothing but your number of reactions or number of unknowns in a structure, and E is nothing but the equation of equilibrium available. So, this will be 3 in case it is a 2D or a plane structure, and it will be 6 in case it is a 3D or a space structure. Okay, so this is how we calculate your external indeterminacy. So for 2D it is R minus 3, and for 3D structure it is R minus 6. See, major of this study what we concentrate is on the 2D structure. So you don't have to bother about the 3D structure. Okay, so this formula is common for whether they are beams, whether they are frames, rigid jointed frames, or pin jointed frames, that's nothing but your truss. Whatever is the type of structure, the external indeterminacy is always calculated using the formula R minus E, where E is either 3 or 6 based on 2D or 3D structure. Okay. Now, coming to your internal indeterminacy. Internal indeterminacy is different for different types of structure. Okay. It will be 0 for beams. So, if it is a beam given, internal indeterminacy is automatically 0. Okay. Now, if it is a frame, it will be 3 into C or 6 into C. So, this will be when it is a 2D or a plane structure. Okay. And it will be 3, if it is a 3D structure, it will be 6 into C. It's a space structure. Okay, now what is C here? C is nothing but the number of closed loops. Say for example, if a frame is like this, this doesn't have any closed loop. So the number of closed loop here will be 0. Suppose same frame I take and we take a member here. Now the number of closed loop here is this one loop will be there. So this is your closed loop. So the number of closed loop here is 1. That is the example. Anyways, in problem we'll see in detail. Okay. So this all is for internal indeterminacy for frames. This is 0 for beams always. Okay. And coming to your pin jointed frames, that's nothing but trusses. It is M minus 2J plus 3. Okay. This is for what? Trusses. Okay. So, what is M? Number of members in the truss. And your J is what? Number of joints in the truss. Okay. So, for a quick review, DSI is 0 for beams, 3C or 6C for plane structure or space structure. See, majorly we will be using plane structure. As I told you, we normally study 2D structures, not 3D structures. Okay. And where, what you see here, it's nothing but the number of closed loops. And coming to trusses, M minus 2J plus 3 is the equation which we use for finding static indeterminacy. Okay. So here in trusses, there's one more importance for internal indeterminacy. Suppose your internal indeterminacy is 0, it's a perfect truss. Okay. Suppose your internal indeterminacy is less than 0, it is a unstable or a under rigid truss. Suppose it is greater than 0, then it is over rigid truss. Okay, so that's nothing but a redundant truss here. In this case, it is a redundant truss. Here it's an unstable truss. here it is a determinate truss, just for your knowledge purpose, okay, in case of pin jointed truss or pin jointed frames, okay. Next topic is your kinematic indeterminacy. Kinematic indeterminacy, also the other name for it is degree of freedom. The number of displacements which we allow, see, the number of equilibrium conditions needed to find the displacement components of all joints of a structure is called as degree of kinematic indeterminacy or degree of freedom. What is the, in simple terms, what is the meaning of kinematic indeterminacy is the number of displacement allowed at a joint of a structure. If normally if it is a 2D structure, there will be three types of displacements which will be allowed. One is the horizontal displacement, one is the vertical displacement, and the other one is the rotation. Okay, so these three will be allowed if it is a 2D structure, right? Now, in few, some will be restricted. So, what kinematic indeterminacy will give us is the number of displacement which are allowed at a joint for a particular type of support. It will give us the kinematic indeterminacy or degree of freedom. The name itself is indicating degree of freedom, D-O-F. Freedom means allowed. So, maximum number of displacement allowed. Okay, that's your kinematic indeterminacy. So, the notation for kinematic indeterminacy is dk. Right, now next let us further see the formula to calculate kinematic indeterminacy. So, kinematic indeterminacy is equal to dk dash plus number of internal hinges. So, here it is addition of internal hinges. In case of static indeterminacy, it is nothing but the subtraction of internal hinges. Right, now dk again is different, dk dash is different for beams and frames and is also different for your trusses. Now how to calculate is using this formula. 3j minus r you have to use for beams and frames, and you have to use 2j minus r for trusses. Already you know what is j, number of joints, correct? And what is R? Number of unknown reactions. Okay, so this is how you will calculate your kinematic indeterminacy. Now, to brief up, if we have to sum up everything, static indeterminacy is the sum of external indeterminacy and internal indeterminacy minus the number of internal hinges. Now, how do you calculate external indeterminacy? It is same for all, right? R minus I'll write the definition for 2D structures. Okay, so R minus 3, here also it's R minus 3, here also it's R minus 3. When it comes to internal indeterminacy, what is the internal indeterminacy for beam? It is 0. For frame, 3 into C. What is C? Number of closed loops. For trusses, what is the value? M minus 2J plus 3. So, this I am summing up all the formulas which we have learnt from the start of this particular lesson. Okay, coming to kinematic indeterminacy. For beams and frames, what is the value for kinematic indeterminacy? 3j minus r. Both here it is same. When coming to the trusses, it is 2j minus r. So, if you remember this table, any type of problem which is given to find static indeterminacy or kinematic indeterminacy, you can find. Okay, so static indeterminacy is dsc plus dsi minus number of internal hinges. Here what is dk? Dk is nothing but dk dash plus number of internal hinges. Please remember these formulas. This is very very important table which you have to remember. Okay, now before getting into the next lesson, let us quickly have a review on the types of supports, how many reactions will each support have, and what is the degree of freedom in each support. Okay, so now as you all know that there can be three reactions if we take a plane structure, plane or a 2D. So what are those three? It may have your horizontal displacement or translation, your vertical displacement or translation, or it can also have some rotation. Right, now based on this, now a free end is allowed to have vertical displacement, it is allowed to have horizontal displacement, as well as it is allowed to have a rotation. So the number of reactions here is 0, reactions are restrictions. There are no restrictions in any of these three. So the number of reactions is 0 here, and the number of degrees of freedom are 3 here. What are the degree of freedom? Horizontal displacement, vertical displacement, and your rotation. Similarly, come to a roller. Roller, what can happen to a roller? It can freely move in your horizontal direction like this. So your delta H is there, but your delta V is restricted. Also, it can have rotation. It can have rotation. So 2 degrees of freedom here. So it can move in horizontal direction as well as it can have rotation. But there is one restriction, which is your delta V. So number of reactions is 1. What is the reaction here? It will have a vertical reaction V, right? So reaction will be coming to a hinge. It will have reaction like this as well as like this. Both horizontal and vertical direction it will have reaction, right? But it is free to only rotate. So number of reactions are 2. What are the reactions? H and V. What are the degrees of freedom available? Only 1, which is equal to theta. Coming to fixed. Fixed has restrictions in all three directions. In all three directions, that means 2 translation and 1 rotation. Everywhere it has restriction. So the number of reactions will be equal to 3 in this case, whereas the number of degrees of freedom will be just, so here it is 3. You will have H, you will have V, as well as you will have M. Here it is 0. Right. Now come to a vertical shear hinge. Now in vertical shear hinges, what will happen is movement also will be restricted. They can only move in one direction kept. Right. Now in this particular case, there will be horizontal restriction, there will be movement restriction, but it is free to move vertically. In this case, there is a vertical restriction as well as a movement restriction, but it is free to move horizontally. Okay. So it's free to move vertically and this is free to move horizontally. So number of reactions here will be how many? 2. What are the reactions? Your horizontal as well as your movement. But restriction is only, degree of freedom is only 1, which is your delta V. Coming to this, again 2, but here in this case V and M are the reactions, and how many degrees of freedom it has? Just has 1 degree of freedom, that is your summation delta H. Now this was types of support. Coming to types of joints, now joints are 2 types. One is the rigid frame joint, the other one is a pin frame joint. So this is a rigid frame joint and this one is a pin frame joint. Now in these joints, how many degrees of freedom are there? Let us have a look, right? So in case of a rigid frame 2D structure, you will have 3 degrees of freedom. All your delta H, your delta V and your theta, right? Coming to space, this will convert to 6 because it's a space frame. We can take it as delta X, delta Y and delta Z in 3 direction translation, then in 3 directions rotations. All these are degrees of freedom if it is a 3D structure. Coming to a plane frame, here movement will not be there, that is rotation will not be allowed. So the number of freedom will be only 2, that is your delta H and delta V in case of your 2D plane is the truss, and in 3D it will be equal to, so here it will be 3 only translations. All the rotations here will be neglected, rotations will not be allowed at all. Okay, there are 3 degrees of freedom in case of a 3D space. Now both your types of support, number of reactions and number of degrees of freedom, as well as types of joints and number of degrees of freedom, this will be very helpful when you go for the problems in the next chapter. Okay.